over here. And this is last week. And this is this week. So last week, on Tuesday, we talked about colonialism and a colony. And on Thursday, we talked about the effects of colonialism. So like, before colonialism, they said the people were happy, plump, they were eating good food, it was beautiful, and then the effects. So after, was everybody plump?
No.
Or skinny?
Skinny.
Yeah, so they were skinny. So they were not plump. Were the people happy?
No.
No.
They were sad. It said they were nervous.
No.
And were they eating a lot of food?
No.
It said they had no food. It said the children were eating, you remember? What were the children eating? It said they were eating garbage. Yes. Yeah, so were these effects, were they good or really bad? Yeah, they were really bad.
How can you eat garbage?
Because they had no food.
And you eat garbage?
If you have no food, maybe you're going to eat the garbage.
It's not making
sense. It's terrible. Yuck.
Yeah.
I know, it's really sad. These are like bad effects, right? Like very bad. So here's today. And today it says, how did Columbus, so this was a man from Italy. So how did this man, Columbus, this man from Italy, affect the people in, oh, and mine looks really bad, North America. So let's look at a map over here. This is, I don't know, whose map is this? Tomas, is this your map?
Yeah.
Yay! Let's look at this map that Tomas made with Efrain.
Yeah.
And just you?
Yeah.
Two people. No. You, Efrain.
Yeah.
Okay. So on their map, here is Europe. And Italy is right here. So this man from Italy came to here, North America. And do you think that he had a good effect on the people or a bad effect? Oh, is this your map, Wasa?
Yeah.
Oh. So on Wasa's map, and Wasa, who'd you work with? Oh, on Wasa and Ismael's map, here, good map, good job. Here is Europe, okay? And Italy is here in Europe. So this man, Columbus, he came from Italy here, and he came to North America. We live in North America. Oregon's right here. Columbus came here and he met the people. Do you think he had a good effect on the people or a bad effect on the people? He had a bad effect. So I'm going to tell you a story about Columbus and what happened to the people, okay? So tell somebody beside you, in English or another language, tell somebody beside you, what am I going to tell you? What will we talk about? So tell them now. one more time. I will tell you a story about the people in North America. And when this man from Italy came to North America, what happened to the people? So tell somebody now, what are we going to learn? So tell Parker. Tell Jane. You tell Wasa, what are we going to learn? This person is a native person, and they live on an island It's not a happy story. It's a sad story. It's a sad, tragic, terrible, but true. Sad story. It happened a long time ago. In 1492. Many, many years ago. Long time ago. So this native person, was born on this island. This island is a true, real, actual island. It's called Haiti. here's the story. This person, is this person happy or sad?
Sad.
Yeah, they're sad. They're telling a sad story. A true, sad, tragic, terrible, horrible, but true story. In 1490, well, we gotta back up. In 1491, this person was not sad. They were happy because Haiti was a beautiful island. The people, the native people, were called the Taino. And the Taino people were happy, and they built beautiful farms. Here's a farm with some animal life. It's a terrible animal, but it's okay. They had farms, there's another animal. They had plants, they had gardens. They built villages. And in the villages were happy people. Happy animals. Happy plants. It was great. This island was beautiful. The people, the Taino people, were happy. The animals were happy. The plants were happy. It was happy. One day, the people, the Taino people, saw in the ocean three boats. One, two, three. Three boats. Three ships. These ships were from Spain. And in one of these ships was a man named Christopher Columbus. This man was he from Spain or Italy? He was from Italy, and he moved to Portugal and Spain and came to Haiti. So this man was Italian. And his name was Christopher Columbus. I'm going to call him Chris. So Chris, Defer Columbus, was an Italian guy, and he was sailing in three boats, three ships, from Spain. And the people on Haiti, the Taino people, looked in the ocean, and they saw these boats. And the boats came here. One, two, three. And some people got off the boats and came on the island. And the Taino people looked at the new people. The people from Spain, Italy, Europe, and they thought, whoa, these people are strange. They're different. They're weird. They're different from us. They said, their skin is a different color. They said their skin was pink. They never saw people with pink skin. This was new. They're like, these people are different. They said these people were wearing a lot of clothes. It was really hot. And so the Taino people, the native people, they thought, wow. These Italian people and Spanish people, they're weird. Their skin is pink. They have a bunch of clothes on. And it's really hot. So Christopher Columbus, this man from Italy, he comes on the island. Here's the island. Here's Christopher Columbus. And he put a flag on there. The flag of Spain. And he said, I claim this island for Spain. And the Taino people were kind of like, huh? This is our land. And Christopher Columbus was like, no, this land is Spain now. So Columbus talked to the Taino people and he said, okay, I want gold. I want lots of gold. I want to be rich. He said, do you guys have some gold for me? And they said, we have very little gold. They have a lot of gold or just a little? So these people, thought, uh-oh, he wants gold. We have gold, but just a little. But he wants a lot of gold. He got really angry, this man, Christopher Columbus. He's like, I want a lot of gold. Give me your gold. They said, no, we can't do that. We have little amount of gold, not much. So Christopher Columbus left. He was angry. He got on his ship, he got in his boat, and he went back to Spain. The people were nervous. They thought, oh no, these people have guns. They did not have any guns. These people had long swords, and they did not have swords. So Christopher Columbus left, and the people thought, maybe he's gonna come back. Then he did come back. But this time, he had not three boats, he had 17 boats. And the boats were full of guns and swords and a bunch of people. And they were all thinking, aha, we're gonna get some gold and be rich. So the people were like really nervous. So then Columbus did something really terrible. He took some people, 500 people, 500 Taino people, and he put them on the boats. And he took them to Spain. And he sold them as slaves. In the ocean, it was terrible. Many people died. and I went to Spain and they sold them to other people to be slaves and work with no money. So 500 Taino were gone.
No.
Dead or sold as slaves in Spain. The rest of the people that were still on the island, Columbus said, I want a lot of gold. You guys, go get me some gold. So they were scared. They were afraid because they had these guns, they had these big swords. So the people were nervous. So they tried and looked and looked. They got gold, brought it to Columbus. I'm just getting a little gold here. And they worked really hard because they were nervous. If they did not bring gold to Columbus, he would cut off their hand. And then they would bleed and die. So, a lot of people were dying. Some people in Haiti, there's mountains. Some people ran away and they hid in the mountains. Some people were so sad they killed themselves. In 2 years, in 1492 and 1493, in 2 years, half of the people, 50% of the people, were dead. In 2 years, half of the Taino people died. But this is how the story ends. Oh, wait. Also, the Spanish people, they cut down all the trees. They destroyed the villages. They destroyed the farms and gardens. Haiti was a beautiful island. But in 2 years, it was very different. And half the people were dead. This is how the story ends. Ahem. This person wrote this story in like 2010. So pretty recently. Is this recent or a long time ago? So this story is pretty recent. And this native person wrote this. They killed almost all of my people. This is the end of the story. Story. We'll read it later. Here's the end. They killed almost all of my people, but not all the Tainos died. Some survived. And we have our stories. The stories of the cruel genocide of my people long, long ago. Genocide means when you kill a lot of people. I told you guys it's a sad story. I'm sorry. You guys want to read this?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll read it to you. Oh, and guess what? This is going to make you mad. Today is a holiday. And the name of the holiday is Columbus Day. Why do we have a holiday for a man who put people in slavery and killed half the people and stole their gold and cut off their hands? Do you think that's right?
No.
So, in Portland, we changed the holiday because many people thought, that's not right. This man Columbus, was he a good guy or bad guy?
Bad.
We don't need a bad guy holiday. So now we have a new holiday in Portland. Some places have Columbus Day. I'm from Georgia. We have Columbus Day in Georgia. In Portland, it's a different holiday. It's called, you might want to write this down, kids, it's called Indigenous Peoples Day. And Indigenous people are the like the Taino people. So it, for us in Portland, it's a different holiday, Indigenous Peoples Day. And Indigenous is like the Taino. It's like Native people. Like Wana, like your language. Mateco. It's an indigenous language. It's a native language, not Spanish. So, I'll read you the story. It's a good story, but it's very sad. Are you guys finished? You want to write? You done? Oh, sorry. Boo is still right. You guys are very patient.
Thank you.
I'm just waiting. Patiently. Thank you. Okay, the story. So this is not me talking. This is the person, the Taino person, okay? This is her story. My people are from an island called Haiti. My people are called the Tainos. They built beautiful farms and villages. They respected the plants and animals. One day, my people saw three boats in the ocean. Strange people got off the boats. The people looked different. They had pink skin. Even though it was very hot, they covered their bodies. Their leader was a man named Christopher Columbus. He put a flag on our land. He said our land was now his land. We thought that was strange. We did not own the land, but we lived there. Christopher Columbus used motions and gestures, like, he couldn't speak to them, right? He spoke different language. So he's like, motions, gestures, to explain that he wanted gold. We told him that we had little gold on our land. We just had a few little pieces. Columbus looked very angry. My people were afraid of his anger. We wondered what he would do next. Columbus left our island. After several months, he came back with hundreds of pink people and 17 boats. They put 500 Taino people on their boats. They took the people to Spain and sold them as slaves. Many people died on the boats. The Spanish people threw their bodies in the water. Columbus said, "Bring me gold or I will kill your people." There was not a lot of gold on our land. It was hard to find. We worked very hard to find gold for Columbus. If we did not bring him enough gold, Columbus would cut off my people's hands. They would bleed to death. My people formed an army to fight Columbus. But the Spanish people had guns and swords and vicious dogs. We had none of these weapons. My people were defeated by the Spanish. My people ran into the mountains. The Spanish looked for my people. Those who were caught were hung like rope or burned to death. Many of my people killed themselves. In 2 years, over half of the Taino people were destroyed. The Spanish cut down our trees. They let their pigs and cows eat all our beautiful plants. They kill almost all of my people. But not all the Tainos die. Some survive. And we have our stories. The stories of the cruel genocide of my people long, long ago. It's a very sad story. And what's really sad is that we have this holiday. I don't know where my calendar went. But today is like this holiday for this man. Oh, thank you. It's a holiday for this guy who killed and cut people's hands off and enslaved people. Raise your hand if you think you like this day better, Indigenous Peoples Day. You prefer this day?
No.
Who would prefer Christopher Columbus Day? Oh, not me. I think this is a good day. I think this is a better day because it honors and celebrates the people who, look at this, they fought. You know, they're brave people, right? They fought, they had an army. It says, my people formed an army to fight Columbus, but the Spanish people had guns and swords and dogs, and so they got defeated. It's a sad story. All right, kids, we're going to write together. If you want to write, you can write on the back. So you have a map, you have a this, right? If you want to write, you can write on the back. If you want to watch, you can watch. Who's going to write? Who's gonna watch? All right, you can write, or you can just look. This is what we think. So, should we or should we not celebrate Columbus Day?
No.
You guys think we should or should not celebrate?
Not so.
Okay, so we're going to say we should not celebrate Columbus Day. All right, so then we're going to say why. So according to Mr. James, I can write down the name of the Taino person who wrote this. Can you look in the book? So this is the author. This is the person who wrote the story.
Tina Thomas.
Okay, Tina, that's my name. Hey. All right, according to Tina Thomas, the author of the story of the Taino.
And she's Cherokee and African American and was a student at Jefferson High School.
She was a teacher in Portland?
No, student.
Oh.
Yeah. Cherokee and African American student at Jefferson High School.
Wow.
This is the untold story, right?
Oh, the untold story. Okay, so that's the actual title. Okay. According to Tina Thomas, and Tina Thomas lived in Portland, and she was a native and African American student at Jefferson High School in Portland. According to Tina Thomas, the author of, so it's called The Untold Story. And then here we have a little quote. And the quote means that we need to put some words from her story. So think about the story. We have to say we should not celebrate Columbus Day. So we need to say some words from the story that show that Columbus was really bad. What in the story showed he's super bad? He was killing people. Is that the worst thing?
Mm-hmm.
So let's find in the story where she writes that he was killing people. Let's see. Ooh, what about this? He would cut off my people's hands and they would bleed to death. Is that bad?
Yeah.
But wait, it says here, if they caught them, they would hang them on like a rope or burn them. Which one's worse? Cutting off their hands or hanging them and burning them?
Burning.
You think they're both bad?
Yeah.
Let's put both. So, according to Tina Thomas, the author of The Untold Story, Columbus would cut, okay, I have to say what she said. Columbus would cut off my people's hands, they would bleed to death. Columbus would cut off my people's hands. Gotta make sure I get it just right. Columbus would cut off my people's hands, they would bleed to death. These quotes, I put quotes because it's her words, not my words. So this shows that Tina Thomas is talking. Okay, TD, let's see what else. Those who were caught were hung or burned to death. Also, putting quotes again because this is her talking. Those who burn to death. Quotes. Okay, I'm going to read what we wrote. We should not celebrate Columbus Day. According to Tina Thomas, the author of The Untold Story, Columbus would cut off my people's hands. They would bleed to death. Also, those who were caught were hung or burned to death. And then it says, this shows that, and so we need to think, what does this show about Columbus? How's what's Columbus like?
Is the light.
What is he like? How is he? Come on, Ethi. He takes gold from people.
Yeah.
So he's greedy.
Yeah. And make people want to
come. So he took gold from people. He's greedy. And what else? Oh, he made them help him.
Yeah, kind of walk.
So first we can say greed,
yes,
because he stole their gold. So this shows that Columbus was a greedy person. Greedy is a person who says, I'll take your land, I'll take your gold, I'll take your people. What else? Yeah, he cut people's hands off. He was very violent. That's terrible. So Columbus was a greedy person who cut people's hands off and was violent and like kind of bossy. You know the word bossy? Like, you go get me some gold. You do what I say, or I'll kill you. So Columbus was a greedy person who was also violent, cutting people's hands off. And the word bossy is not quite fancy enough, Mr. James. How could I say it? Because this is like school writing. And bossy is kind of like what I say in my house.
Demanding.
Yes. Like Avdi said, he said, you give me this gold, and if you don't, I will kill you. That is demanding. Nicely done. Wow, well done, kids. I think it's time to go.
Yeah.
I think you should put your name on your calendar and give it to me so that we don't have to lose them again. What do you think? Just give it to me when you leave, okay?
Are you collecting this sheet from them also?
Well, they didn't have this sheet. We just,
oh,
some people wrote it.
Okay,
yeah,
sorry.
Some people
sorry.
Just
okay.
wrote it on the back.
Cool.
Yeah.